Hello, this is Overlord Bo, and we're back. Today, we're going to be covering the newest collab for World of Warships. The new Star Trek collab has started. So, let's hop right into it and start talking about. So, pretty much there are four ships in this collab. There is the Enterprise, which is pretty much everyone's favorite at this point. There is the Akatsuki, which is for the Romulans. And, of course, the Enterprise is going to be for the Terrans. The Gneisenau is going to be for the Vulcans. And, of course, the Fiji is going to be for the Klingons. So there's four ships with four different factions from the Star Trek universe. And each of them will have their own separate commanders, except for Spock, where Spock is going to be both for... is going to be both the American for both Picard and Spock. So the Vulcans do not get a commander, unfortunately. But you can still do a trick to have Spock on the Vulcan ship, but and I'll explain that in a little bit. In this port, there's a lot of little goodies and little Easter eggs you can do. You can open up all the doors. You can pick on all of the buttons here. You can open the door here, click on the walls, click here. You're also able to click on like little phasers or readers here to make little noises and things. I feel like there's an Easter egg somewhere in here and that people are gonna figure out sooner or later, but it's super cool to be in the Enterprise on the bridge. It's super cool. You can also go down, beam down to the planet, which is also super cool. And you're able to see your ship in the water. You can see the Enterprise up in the air, up there, up in space. So super cool. And you also click by, you can go back by clicking on one of the shuttles. I've seen a lot of people getting stuck on the play and not figuring out how to get out. And well, there's a trick. You just click on the shuttle to get back to the ship. You beam yourself up. So if you go in the armory, we'll talk about a little bit of each of the Star Trek clubs going on. Pretty much you can gamble either, and you can only get three of the camos from the container, because of course, if you don't have the Enterprise, there's really no point in getting, you know, the camo for it. The rest of these ships are able to get done in the tech tree, so that's why the camos available are only for the Gneisenau, Akatsuki, and the Fiji. You can gamble to get Picard, Spock, Sela, and Gowron. So you guys can do that. And I think that these commanders are actually really well done. And what I plan on doing is I plan on going into the port with the ships, and you guys are able, not the ship, in the game. I'm going to go to a training room. You guys can see how each of the ships are, and you guys can kind of see how the guns are for each of the ships and the aircraft are for the Enterprise. So you guys can take a look at that in a moment. I'm just going to go over the bundle here. So pretty much you can get all four commanders for 5,100 doubloons. That's about $20. I think overall this deal is going to be the best if you want to get each of the commanders with a special voiceovers. They are 10 points. But there is also an alternative here in the combat missions. If you do start playing during this patch, there is a mission to the stars where you can get either Gowron or Sela. You can get one or the other by completing these missions, which are really easy to do. I would personally get Gowron. I like Gowron a little bit more than Sela, but that's just more of a personal preference in the end there. Now, something to note when you're buying these bundles, if you do decide to do it. So if you pretty much, if you buy the Klingon bundle here, you get a discount for 30 days on purchasing the ships leading up to the Fiji. It makes it where if you don't have the Fiji, you're able to go down the line really quickly. It's going to be a really easier grind to do that. It's the same for the Romulan ship as well. If you get the Japanese researchable ships, you get a discount of 50% and 30% all the way up to the Akatsuki, so you can get them quicker. Now, unfortunately, Spock doesn't get one of these special bundles. His special bundle is only in the Star Trek thing, which is kind of disappointing. It does cost 24,000 doubloons, which I don't really think it's worth it. With the price that big, it's really, really expensive just for camos and for some discounts. It's really, really expensive. But if you want to whale for it, you can as well. One thing to note, like I said before, as you can see, Picard is a U.S. commander for the Enterprise. Now, you would think that Spock would also be would be a German commander since he's in the Vulcan area, but he's not. He is an American commander. So definitely take note of that before you buy this bundle, even though it does look like he would be part of the German commander. He's not. He is an American commander, so make sure you do not forget that. Now, some of you may say, well, he, of course, served on the Enterprise, so of course he would be on it, so that makes perfectly sense to some, but the fact that he's in this Vulcan area but isn't on, like, the German commander tree is kind of weird, in my opinion. So, for the Romulans, you get the Sela, and then you get, for the Klingons, you get Gowron for it. You also get 10.5 million credits. And you get the discounts for the German, the Japanese, and the British for this. But again, I don't really think this bundle is worth it. I don't think so at all. If you do want to get the individual commanders, you do. You can get Picard. You can buy them separately here. And you can also test out your voice lines yourself here. Provide anti-aircraft fire support. And I think that these commanders is all really well done. A battle worthy of a song! I think all of these voiceovers are really well done. Regroup at the strategic point. And I think it's really high quality voiceovers. That was rather unexpected. Compared to some of them in the past, I think these are really well done and professionally done. And I think the voice actors did a really good job when they were recording these lines for each of their characters. So personally, I really love these. Love these voiceovers, are really nice. Now, something to note that there is a trick to where even though Spock is he is an American commander, you can't use him on the Gneisenau now. If you do decide to get that bundle and get the Gneisenau now with this special camo here, if you want to have them on your ship, all you gotta do is go into settings, go into audio, and scroll down to the bottom where it says extended. Now, you have to have the commander to do this, right? You have to have the commander. If you don't have the commander, this isn't going to show up. You then scroll down to the bottom of the list. As you can see right here, it has all of the commanders right here from the Star Trek collab, since I do have them. And all you have to do is just click Spock, and there you go. So then whenever you go into battle using the Gneisenau with the Vulcan camo, Then you're able to have Spock overhearing or commanding your vessel while in the battle. So super cool. It's just a little trick. If you want to get that big bundle and you want to get this really cool camo, then you can do that. Now let's just take a quick look at them in port here. So this is the Enterprise. Very cool. Very detailed. Has the numbers on the top with the aircraft on top. Very cool design, has the signature thing in the front. Very cool. I love this. This is one of my favorite camos for sure. I'm a weak spot for the Klingon. The Klingon one is really good. Like, look at this. Oh, that looks so good in my opinion. I love how like the wings just warp around the hole there on the side. It's a really, really cool design. I like it a lot. Super, super, super cool. The next one is going to be the Romulan for the Akazuki. This one isn't my favorite. It's one of my least favorite, but I think they did the best they could do for a DD. But again, it's still a really cool piece for them to do. I think it's super cool, and people that like the Romulans will definitely like this camo along with Sela. Super cool pairing. The last one is going to be the Gneisenau now. Of course, this one is the Vulcan one, like we were saying. This one to me is pretty much the coolest one. The secondaries, along with the main guns, with the hole in the middle, with how it's designed the hull, is really just adds a really cool touch to the Gneisenau now. Even though the Gneisenau is definitely not one of the most popular ships, it's probably one of the least ones for Tier 7. It definitely makes it a lot more fun to play with that super cool camo. Now, I'm going to switch over to showing each ship in battle in a training room so you guys can take a look at those.
Having is not so pleasing, after all, as wanting.
All right, so this is the Gneisenaut with the Vulcan camo, like I was saying earlier. I really love how in-depth this camo is with the rain going off of it and the guns, which I'll show you in a second. I'll get closer to the enemy so you guys can pretty much see how secondaries fire as well, but I just love the sound the guns give off. As you can see as well, the water also breaks off the side of the camo heel, which I think is a really cool detail. It does this on all of the camos. In the past, we haven't really seen camos have this kind of realistic side to it, so it definitely shows the detail that Wargaming put into these camos themselves. Something that's really cool is that there is a special horn for all four of the different camos. The Gneisenaut has the only one that's different from the three. The rest of them are pretty much identical. The Gneisenaut does have the only separate one the Vulcan one does, so special in that regard. So this is what it sounds like when the guns are firing, so you guys can kind of get a little taste for that. And when you're launching your torpedoes and your guns are firing. So this is a little taste of the Gneisenaut camo. And a little bit of taste of the voiceover as well. The next ship is going to be the Enterprise with the Picard captain. So you guys can just listen to that for a minute.
Let's see what this warship can do. Computer, autopilot mode on. Deal with this warship right away. Fighter airborne.
So as you can hear, it does have a machine gun animation, and then it has the little photon torpedoes that it does. That's pretty much how it works for the attack fighters. I'll next do this demonstrate how it does for the torpedoes, and I'll do the drop bombers next. And then we'll do the Akazuki next to showcase the Romulan ship and commander. And like I was saying before, you guys can also go in port, or you can go on the armory on the website as well to listen to the voiceovers, and you can listen to them as much as you want while you go in the armory to potentially buy them. So if you guys want to listen to the voiceovers more, you can always go to armory and do that as well.
We've reached the final destination. Keep on exploring new horizons. Computer.
Almost forgot to showcase the horn of the Enterprise, so you guys can listen to that. So the next ship is going to be the Akazuki for the Romulan Empire, with Sela.
The time for action is now. Let the battle commence.
Yes, so as you can see, it does have this pretty much the same gun animations as the Gneisenaut, but since it's Romulan, they are green. So the lasers are more green instead of the orange of the Vulcan. But as you can see, the shells are still pretty much the same. It's just this little fire animation is it's just a different color based off of whatever faction they are.
Engine boost activated. Smoke generator started.
That is going to be the showcase for the Akazuki, and let's move on to the final one for the Fiji of the Klingon Empire. All right, so the final ship showcase and commander is going to be Gowron and the Fiji Camo.
The battle is upon us! Focus on this enemy!
But yeah, the gun sounds for this particular ship I like the most out of the four ships from this collab. To me, they just sound the smoothest and the cleanest to me personally. But if you guys have your own personal favorite, definitely let me know in the comments down below. But you guys can just sit back and listen for a moment while I just showcase a little bit of the stuff.
Hydroacoustic surge activated. Smoke generator started. Let computer lead the way. I'll do it myself. Smoke screen set.
All right, so with that out of the way, let's talk about again about the bundles that are there. So we already talked about the commanders, right? We talked about the commander bundles and what I think about those. Now let's talk about the camo bundles that are right here and also the Star Trek one, right? Now, again, you can gamble for them if you want, but we're just going to talk about them here. The Enterprise bundle here, this is the only way you're able to get the Enterprise besides paying it here. So you can only get the Enterprise either in the 7,500 doubloons here or in the large pack here. The Klingon and the Romulan pack, you get the Commander and the Bird of Prey camo here. And the Romulan Warbird here camo along with the Sela Commander here. And this one you get the Gowron Commander here. In this bundle, you get Picard and the Enterprise camo. Just for you guys to know, you do not get the Enterprise in the bundle. You have to have the Enterprise already if you are wanting to put the camo onto the ship. So, no, you cannot buy the Enterprise in this. There is no way to get it. The way you can get it right now is from Santa containers, and I think it's like one of those special aircraft containers that they sell every now and again. Somebody in the comments can let you guys know. I don't remember the name on top of my head, but that's the only way how you can get the Enterprise. The Enterprise camo, it's really cool, but unless you have the Enterprise, it's kind of worthless to you. So if you want to get Picard, you can buy the Picard for 2250 doubloons. Me personally, I like the Klingon bundle the most. I like his commander. I like Gowron's commander the most. I like it's really good. Along with the camo, looks amazing. Romulan the one I'm not as big of a fan of just because I don't like the camo as much. So I'm not the biggest fan of that one. And the only way that you can get the Vulcan camo is by the large Tartrack bundle. So if you guys want to buy, if you want to get that particular camo, you're going to have to fork over 24,000 doubloons. And 24,000 doubloons is $100. So if you want to do that, you can. But again, up to you guys. It's your guys' money. Do whatever you like. I'm just trying to give you guys options that you can see here. So we went over the commanders. We went over the packs. We went over the Star Trek commanders. I showcased all of the camos for you guys. So you guys could get a taste of them as well. You guys could also come in here as well, in the armory or on the website and click on...
Unleash your wrath upon their flying machines!
You can click there or here to get a random phrase from their special voiceover. But yep. So that is the showcase of the Star Trek collab. I hope you guys enjoyed the showcase. If you guys have any questions or concerns, definitely know in the comments down below. Oh, I almost forgot. The coolest thing as well is when you're doing the port, you can go in here. It goes to the room where you can summon your containers. Super cool. I saved two containers just for you guys. So, very cool. I'm very happy with the Star Trek collab. Even if you don't buy anything, I feel like this whole collab is definitely on par with the Star Trek franchise themselves. So, very happy with the quality of this overall collab. And again, if you guys don't buy anything, you are able to get a commander for free by doing combat missions. All you have to do is go over to Common, look at To the Stars. You can get either Gowron or Sela for free. As long as you complete these, you can then claim the prize and get yourself a free Star Trek commander. But thank you guys for watching. If you guys have any questions or concerns, definitely let me know in the comments down below. And I will talk to you all later.